この映画は君に撮ってもらうから頼んだわよ、ジーン監督。
It's very rare that you watch a film that embodies so much of your passions, but also presents it in a way to make it feel like the movie was made just for you. That's the exact experience I had while watching Pompo the Cinephile. I was pulled in by its amazing animation and never let go from its story about filmmaking and the love of cinema. As someone who's always wanted to be a filmmaker, Pompo struck a special chord in my heart, making it an experience I've never really had before. The film opens with a film reel rolling through, showing you some quick cuts of pieces of the film later down the timeline, and we cut to a woman singing at the film's Oscar equivalent award show. As the opening song talks about the film industry and the world that the film takes place in, Nollywood, we get character introductions like opening film credits, and this song is straight fire. The English version's pretty terrible though. After the intro song that's reminiscent of a musical, we cut to Gene, our main character, as a production assistant working on a busy set. Once he gets a break, he begins taking notes of everything happening in his surroundings, and immediately you know how obsessive he is to learn every aspect of filmmaking. At this point, he's been working for a year under Pompo, the young granddaughter of a legendary film producer who's made quite a name for herself. Currently at this point in her career, she only produces B-movies, but one day Gene's taking a bus to work when he sees a girl running down the street, and we get one of my favorite scenes of the entire film, showcasing that he sees certain moments in the world through camera lenses, as he has a natural eye for film. This vision also makes him miss his stop on the bus, adding to his awkward, clumsy nature. We transition to Gene arriving late to the audition, where the girl he saw earlier is leaving with her spirit crushed. I love the transitions in this film. It honestly probably has some of my favorite scene transitions of all time. They head to the screening room to see Marine, which was the film they were working on at the beginning of the movie. And honestly, I would totally watch this if it was a real movie. Again, Gene is taking notes during the film, gushing in his head about how Pompo is just a film genius. After the screening, Gene sees Pompo's legendary grandfather and asks him, "What is the secret to making a great film?" To which he replies, "You need a sharp eye for visuals, from actors to capturing the world," to which he asks Gene if he wants to make a movie. Gene replies in a panic that not in his wildest dreams he ever would. Peterson, Pompo's grandfather, comforts him by saying Pompo chose him for a reason because she can see something in him. After finding his notebook in the theater, Pompo sees him talking to her grandfather, and she decides to have Gene make a 15-second trailer for Marine. She ramps up the pressure on him as he begins to edit. The way the film chooses to present film editing and its animation is absolutely breathtaking and extremely truthful to someone who just loves to video edit. Using a sword to visualize digital film splicing, symbolizing how old methods and standards have morphed into the current digital standards of today, is something that is wildly imaginative and kind of simple at the same time. It's awesome. After finishing the 15-second short, which Pompo and Marine's director enjoyed, Gene questions why she picked him. She basically tells him that he has no sparkle in his eye, claiming that most talent comes from people who run away from reality to create their own. Their drive to escape from their day-to-day, that mental or emotional turmoil, is what drives creativity, to which Gene wears on his face in the film, even having gray eyes with grayish purplish bags underneath them. The next day, Gene returns to find the script for Meister, written by Pompo. Love the taxi driver phone screen here. When Pompo returns, she asks Gene what he thought of the script, to which he begins a deep analysis and summarizing it in a very visual sense. You can tell Pompo is pleased with every answer because she has Gene direct the film.
Gene-kandoku.
That's pretty much the first 20 minutes of the film, and where I'm going to stop spoiling the film. I thought it was necessary to talk about the setup of the film to be able to talk about the back end without spoiling the film. From here on out, it's pretty much Gene, Pompo, and the group making the film in two different arcs. The first arc being the actual filmmaking process, which presents moments of creative teamwork, the hard work going into making a film, and what feels like an accurate representation, if be it a bit tearful, of being on a set. Using moments of nature and studio setting to capture tones and character moments that were spontaneous, and during this segment you really get to capture Gene coming into his own, and finding his confidence and finally being able to express himself. He finally gets to be a part of that creative process of his passion. We also get to spend some time with Natalie, an inspiring actress who Pompo casts as a lead in Meister. We get a small montage segment with her as she struggles from audition to rejection, and finally getting her big break and what pressures and hard work it takes. Another thing I really loved is how the film presents the film in the film Meister by changing the animation and presentation. Changing the letterboxing, harshing character lines, and using bolder colors and lighting to make it stand out from the rest of the film. Everything in the film's presentation feels so meticulous and purposeful. Even when Gene meets Martin Braddock, who's reminiscent of Marlon Brando, Gene is literally blew back by his star power. There's so much attention to detail that even on multiple watches, there's something new to see, a new connection to make, or maybe an Easter egg that's just a flash in the pan without making a note to it, that makes a film like this so much fun to watch. The last real act of the film is the editing process and finding the film within what they filmed. How Gene's obsession and passion fuels restless nights to find his vision of the film, to also find who he's making the film for. I love this section of the film. They say when you make a film, you really make multiple films. You make the film you write, you make the film you shoot, and you make the film you edit. And the film really presents this philosophy, which is showcased as Gene deletes scenes and starts over trying to piece together this puzzle. I love the exposition here to convey why Gene is making the decisions he's making, how he second guesses himself, and how those changes affect the tone, character, and composition of the scene. This section of the film is also where Gene really finds his creative stride and confidence as an artist, as he wants to stay true to his vision. As Gene is cutting the film, you can also see the parallel lines drawn between Gene, the story of the film Meister, and the film's main character D'Albert, as art imitates life. Gene really finds himself within this movie.
監督になったじゃない。
I went into Pompo with about the expectation that it looks enjoyable and that I'm a sucker for anime or movies about the filmmaking process, but I was completely floored by Pompo the Cinephile. The way the film visualizes the mood, mental state, and the process of not only filmmaking, but also artistic expression is honestly what impressed me the most. Everything about this film on a presentation side blew me away and connected me with Gene and the emotional beats of the film that most films rarely do. Even a scene where Gene is just sitting watching a movie with a wall of movies behind him, it's just very easy for me to connect with that character. Also love the fact that the film presents the idea that Pompo believes the perfect runtime for a movie is 90 minutes due to her childhood upbringing, and Gene cutting Meister to be 90 minutes to the actual movie itself, rolling credits at 90 minutes, which also feels like a call to Pompo not sticking around for credits after movies in the movie, which feels like a rabbit hole conspiracy theory that just kind of blows my mind. Gene, Pompo, and Natalie are all deeply rich characters with developed backstories and history, Gene having the largest arc in character growth, but even some of the side characters can have small arcs and development that makes the world of Nollywood feel lived in and wide. Its cheerful and hopeful tone, the discovery of artistic expression, and the capturing of creativity carries a triumphant feel-good tone that will easily put Pompo in my list of pick-me-up films. This is one of those films I could easily spend hours talking about every minute detail and decision in the film. Maybe I'm thinking too far into certain segments and moments, but that's what makes a film like this so much fun for me. As a cinephile myself and someone who wants to be a filmmaker with a heavy preference on video editing, this is a rare occasion where a film felt like it was made for me and I absolutely loved it.
一番気に入ってるのは上映時間が90分ってところですね。